following him because I know you watch YouTube. You've seen old videos of Nate breaking down the Lord's name, Yahweh and Yahweh Shai. But all of a sudden now, don't nobody know the name. We're not supposed to call on the name when the scriptures tell us to call on the Lord's name. Matter of fact, go back to James 1:1-8. Y'all need to stop, man.
Well, we listen to, we check out ISUK too.
No, you need to stop because Junior Johanna telling folks you could have sex with your woman in the butt and that's sodomy. Why would you follow a man like that? See what I'm saying? Give me that James 1:8.
James 1:8. A devil-minded man is unstable in all his ways.
That's why Nate is contradicting himself. Remember, Nate was teaching y'all about conspiracy theories, how they nut. But then he come out with a teaching about the RFID chip. He was getting on us a great millstone for teaching that the mark of the beast is the RFID microchip. Now Nate is saying the same thing. So that's being a double-minded man. Like the scriptures say, he is unstable in all his ways. And then Nate sold out. He got a 501c3 charter, but he tell y'all that's progress. No, that's selling out to the government.
Yeah, I hear that. I seen some videos. I think it was DMS. I seen a bunch of videos about the 501c3.
Yeah, that's selling out to the government. Because see, already a church is protected by the Constitution. You don't have to sell out to the government for a 501c3. See what I'm saying? The church is already protected between church and state. So why would you sell out for a 501c3? That's to get more money.
Okay.
See what I'm saying? When you're supposed to depend on the Lord to provide for you. Yeah, we work and everything, but the Lord still take care of. We don't have to go sell out to the white man, our enemy.
Hey.
What sense does that make? So that means what? Nate is being a double-minded and unstable in all his ways. One minute he's saying this, calling us a great millstone bumite, but then he cut himself by calling us a faith-based camp. That's a compliment for us. Why? Because we're depending on faith. We're not calling him Christ or Jesus. That's not his name. The Lord is a Hebrew. You mean to tell me you can have a Hebrew name, but the Lord don't deserve a Hebrew name? See what I'm saying?
Right.
Y'all need to quit following him, man, for real. Y'all need to stop following him because Nate is going to lead you down a path of destruction, you and your homeboy on the phone.
Yeah, we don't necessarily follow him. We listen to the teaching.
Don't listen to no more of his teaching. Follow real men. I'm not going to tell you to follow Great Millstone, even though those are the realest men on the planet. But I'm going to leave it up to you. But quit following Nate. Don't follow ISUBK, GOCC, none of them. Those are false prophets. See what I'm saying? Because see, Nate trying to justify his wickedness. He all about money. He not about salvation for his brethren. Just like the Passover he had last year. Now the Passover is a solemn assembly, right? So why is you having a dating service at your Passover? Yes, at the Passover they had last year, was that in Florida? They have trying to play matchmaker during the Passover. You don't supposed to do that during the Passover.
Fly.
Yeah. Go ahead. Talk. I can fly.
Yeah, see y'all, y'all in the same area.
Yeah.
Now, that'd be my son, he just got I'm moving down here, but I just wanted to catch y'all again, man, see what's camping on. There's a bunch of traffic right here.
We be bouncing around. We go downtown too.
Right, okay.
Actually, I don't. I left them at the house, man. But all you gotta do is go on YouTube and type in Great Millstone.
Great
Millstone. Yeah, or type in GMS Main Camp. You see what I'm saying? Those are our apostles and elders, Apostle Tahar. I know you heard of Apostle Tahar. Nate always talking about it.
Not really. Everybody can get a lot from GPS, to be honest. You know what I'm saying? I think they threw me off with GMS. You know, it's a lot of negative feedback on GMS, ISPK, each camp. You know what I'm saying? So I think the thing that threw me off with GMS, I'm not sure if it was that particular camp, but it was out in the house. they was kind of throwing racist slurs towards Asians that was walking by, one of the Asians spitting one of their faces. I don't know if it was DMS, but I don't know which camp that was. You ever see that, bro?
Well, you just answered your question, because if it was a GMS camp and the Asian walked by and spit on him, well, you got the right to retaliate.
Well, no, the spitting happened due to, because they was lashing out at everybody who wasn't black, basically, that was walking by. They were just being kind of belligerent with everybody, just, oh, this changing, this, that, he gets put in the cash, you know what I'm saying? So they were just kind of attacking people verbally.
I didn't see the video, so I don't know if it was a GMS camp or somebody else, but we don't act like that.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? All we do is teach the word. Now, if you come against the word, we're gonna chastise you through the scriptures. No, words may come out, but that's part of battle. We're in spiritual warfare.
Right.
We ain't got time to, if you're sitting up here talking against the scriptures, we ain't gonna say, okay, brother, well, you know, blah, blah, blah. Nah, you cursing us out, we're gonna curse you back out. We men. That's how men battle.
Right.
See what I'm saying? Do you think in the ancient days, when they were war, they, hey, brother, don't stab me right here. I just got kicked by a horse, stab me. No, they don't care where you got hurt or whatever. This is battle. They're gonna stab you in your eye, throat, neck, whatever.
Right.
See what I'm saying? It's all about survival. That's what we're trying to do, is survive so the Lord can come and beam us up out of here, man.
Right.
See what I'm saying? So we ain't got time to play games with nobody, man. Either you're going to get down with the program, or the Lord is going to destroy you. Matter of fact, give me Deuteronomy. See? The word is out there, man. Right. But see, you can follow, matter of fact, all that. Glad you brought that up. Give me Galatians. This is what it says about that. Because see, they teach you it's all about following the law, following the law, following the law. Well, if that's the case, then why is it they getting lined up to shape up? That's breaking the commandments of the Lord. Scripture tell you not to maul your beard around the corners of your head. So you know that's what we get lined up to shape up. So that's being a double-minded man. Give me Galatians chapter 3, verse 10. This is what the Lord had to say about this.
Galatians chapter 3, verse 10. For as many as are of the works of the law are under the curse, for it is written, cursed is everyone that continueth not in all things which are written in the book of the law to do them. But that no man is justified by the law.
You hear that? It's, hold on, it said verse 11.